think we can start. Can everybody hear me? Sound check, just in case. Yay! It's the last thing I need is something breaking on the voice. Awesome. Welcome, everybody. I see we have some new faces here. Welcome, welcome. Going through our usual disclaimer, so please be aware there's certain things we can't discuss with you, that's including any kind of abuse appeals or suspensions, terminations, information or outcomes of certain investigations and abuse reports, all that fun stuff. But otherwise, feel free to ask any questions. If you have any feedback, we're all ears. So, done with that, as I make random gestures with my hands that you cannot see. So, let's get started. Does anybody have any questions or anything they want to start with? Also, feel free to type if you don't want to do voice. That's completely understandable. If there are some Nazi stuff and swastikas, feel free to report it and we will check into it. Most of the time we do slap that down because that is not appropriate, especially if it's just being used for trolling and being inappropriate and all that fun stuff. So if there's a particular person that's using it, or if it's somewhere in the marketplace, feel free to report it and we'll take a look at it. Yeah, no problem. Alrighty. Well, hopefully that won't happen again. See if I can catch up on what I was reading about earlier. Dear, it was just so strong. So strong. See, places where band lines extend into, if it's a Linden roadway, it's usually, we'll see the reports and take a look. See what else I missed. I spy a Tommy. Does anybody have any other questions on scrolling up and catching up? So we do see people who occasionally they try and get their buddies to like file a ton of reports on somebody. Just because someone files an abuse report on somebody, or just because a bunch of people file an abuse report on somebody, does not automatically mean that they're going to get in trouble. We still investigate and try and verify if what they're doing is a violation that we can step in on. If there's no evidence of any sort of violation, we don't do anything. So just simply having a bunch of people mass report on somebody doesn't really do much. Though if someone's doing it to abuse the system, like trying to flood abuse reports, then we might have to step in and be like, hey, don't do that. Yeah, usually a lot of the abuse, if there's a bunch of abuse reports on a single person, it does get our attention because we're like, whoa, what's going on? But sometimes it could indicate that you know, maybe someone's griefing and it's hitting a bunch of different regions and a bunch of different people are reporting it. But we still go through and investigate properly. But sometimes it'll just be, you know, one or more people and their friends just copy and pasting the same thing and, you know, just trying to get someone in trouble where we always prefer that the person affected is the one that does the report because they're going to have the information firsthand instead of, you know, playing that telephone game. Fortunately, we have not evolved to the point where you can actually smell things in Second Life, which is probably for the best because I've seen some things that I don't want to smell. Hopefully, at that. Oh, that's cool. I've got a couple of gacha toilets that Tommy sent me to, and they amuse me like hell. If it's a case of, if it's someone intending to deceive someone in the marketplace by selling something and there's nothing in the item, we might step in and smack. If it's from someone who hasn't been on in ages and their store is just really old and not updated, we might step in. It really depends on the situation. But there's a lot of, like, all sorts of fun little policy things that we have to adhere to for marketplace things. So I think there might be something going on in the future that I can't remember if we can tell you or not. So I'll just leave that there. But yeah, if you do have, you know, a case where it seems like something is not working, you can send in a case or, you know, and we'll take a look and see if it's something that we can help. Because if it's something where it's old and it's just not functioning, the person's no longer in Second Life, I don't see any reason why, you know, if people aren't getting what they're paying for, we can, you know, poke at it and see what we can do. That's what I'm talking about, really. I couldn't remember. We got a lot of stuff floating in my head. So, yeah. So, for things like that, you can definitely submit a ticket. We do handle marketplace tickets, and there's a whole section under that when you do file a case. So, just file it under a marketplace case, and we'll check it out with all, you know, of course, provide all the information, the listing, the store, all that fun stuff. Yeah, it's kind of the problem with a product that's, you know, over 15 years old. There's a lot of old stuff just hanging around. See, any other questions while I catch up, see if I missed anything else? Yeah, if you have something that's encroaching on Linden land, you could definitely report it. I think there is a report category for it, but we'll take a look and see what we can do. If it's something that we can just simply return, but obviously we don't want to return like a giant thing that's attached to a larger structure, so we might reach out to them. It depends on the situation, but we definitely will check it out and see what we can do, especially if it's blocking some from using a, you know, a road or something like that. You've had a few cases where people are just, you know, building on things, and then they have like a giant just cardboard box just chilling in the road. I'm like, no, don't do that. That is indeed a wall of text. Let's see. Let's see. It looks like it's a twofold question. So we don't actually, anything that's, you know, regarding, you know, someone's intellectual property and stuff like that, that's all, support doesn't handle that. That's a whole legal thing with DMCAs, and they got to file that. But when it comes to someone who owns a region and, you know, kicking people off their region, someone can kick or ban someone off their region for whatever reason they see fit. That's not for us to intervene with. So if they, you know, someone could be like, you know, oh, we don't allow anybody wearing flip-flops and hats on this region. If someone walks in wearing flip-flops and hats, they can kick them from their region if they want to. So that's their particular thing. So we don't, you know, deal with that. And on the flip side, sometimes we get the reports of, like, someone filing an abuse report, say, you know, for example, if someone has a little rule in their region where, you know, you can't wear flip-flops because they hate flip-flops for whatever reason. And then they file an article, like, they're wearing flip-flops on my region. We don't action on that because it's not our rule. That's whatever. As long as they're, you know, not violating our rules. But, yeah. But, in short, their region, their rules, as long as they aren't impeding on other things. Sounds like a not a very pleasant smell. So glad we don't have virtual smell technology. So glad. A person feels that their product is being stolen and misused in any way, they need to file a DMCA. And only the person who owns that copyright can do it. So if you think somebody else is using somebody else's content, you can't really file anything on that. So sometimes we'll see reports and we will reach out and educate on how to actually properly do that. And then the appropriate team that handles all the DMCA fun times looks into it further. Yep, if you happen to know the creator, you can definitely let them know, and then they can do it from there and take any necessary steps they need to for their content. I can't really comment on that since I don't really know, we don't really have a lot of insight as to what goes on whenever a DMCA is filed, because that is definitely a legal process between the content owner and all that fun stuff. So we don't know, you know, what information was brought up and what evidence they have and all that fun legal mumbo jumbo. We usually look at encroachment cases case by case. If it's something where it's obviously impeding, then we'll step in. But we just review and see if it is an issue, and send education if we can. If it's not like a huge, huge thing, if it's not blocking anything, we might, you know, reach out to the person and be like, hey, just so you know, you might want to not do that. Are you, Tommy? Are you really joking?
Not. Maybe you'll never know. But word of advice, if we return something, don't put it back. Talk to us first.
Yeah, that's usually never a good idea. If we return something, there's usually a reason. Yeah, it really just depends on, it's definitely a case-by-case basis thing. It just really depends on what's going on and how bad the encroachment is. And if possible, we'll reach out and get it all sorted. But if you do have something that's extending on where it's encroaching where it shouldn't be, don't be surprised if it does get returned. Because, you know. So what we focus on is if someone's being reported for a term of service, I don't care who you are. If you're violating the rules, we will step in and do what's necessary. So premier or not, it doesn't really make a difference. If you do something bad, we gonna slap you. So. Yeah, I will Liam Neeson you. I will find you. Oh, I don't bother what yours. I'll just take your account. Give you a nice little slap. One of the things. Depends on what's going on. But yeah. I'm only scary when you violate the rules, and then I get going. Oh, yeah, what Tommy said. If you're reporting something that's owned by, you know, us, and it's in the way, the land team will poke at it if necessary. So they do all kinds of crazy hard work, and I, you know, don't want to touch or break any of that. Do not want to anger the land team. Looks like we've got a little bit less than 3 minutes left, so if anybody has any other questions, feel free to throw them at me. So maybe not physically, because that might hurt. Or if anybody has any fun campfire stories, let's see. In the right spot for it, cue for it. Do you deck the halls with toilets? That's a mental image. Glorious. Unfortunately, I don't have any info on that chaser. We don't deal with land, so that's all kind of over my head. That would be better directed towards... not sure which team that would be, actually. So you're talking about estates.
If you're talking about mainland, which I think you are... you have advice or just thoughts, feedback, etc., submit a ticket. We'll make sure it goes to the land team.
Yep. Well, there you go. Next land meeting, you can direct any of those questions there.
I don't think that's the land team meeting. I think that's my team's meeting.
Well then, maybe not. Someone's meeting. Let me check.
Land does sometimes come to our meetings. If Kira is there, it's a good time to bring it up. But if she's not there, then you probably won't get an answer that you're looking for. Land does sometimes come to them. Usually it's my team, though, which would be concierge.
Ah, yes, I see the confusion.
And concierge can answer questions about private regions and stuff, but mainland is actually handled by the land team.
And I may or may not have an unrelated answer. Go for it. Easter eggs certainly sound exciting. Alright. Let's see. Anything else going on? Also, I'm not aware of any whiteboards, but I could also just be not paying attention. So we have been seeing a lot less hardcore griefing than what we used to see in the past. There's some things that have been going on, but, you know, and we've been very, very busy in making sure that we stop what we can. Of course, it's not going to stop. People are just being very, very persistent and creative. But we've been doing a lot of work to help decrease and prevent it. Though it still does happen, but it's not as I haven't seen, you know, a few years ago. It used to be crazy. You know, we'd be very, very busy. And all sorts of different things. So it'd be, you know, something different every day. It'd be like, well, here's a bunch of particle spammers today. Here's a hidden pixel of doom that's crashing regions today. But yeah, we've been seeing a lot less of that, which is very nice. And hopefully it's making everybody happy not having to deal with that. Yep, we've been noticing a little bit less issues with sandboxes as well, which is always nice. Yeah, there's always going to be those few that are going to be butts and try and just irritate people. But so we do our best whenever those do happen, when they're reported, and we do take the appropriate action and clean up. But it's definitely not as bad as it used to be. But there's still some pockets where griefing does happen and people are just jerks, and can't really stop people from being jerks, but I can smack them for it and return their stuff. There shouldn't be any incidents where you cannot report. If you're not able to report because A, you don't know where the item is, or you can't get on the region, you can always report from another region and just be sure that you are being very clear what the region is that's being affected. If you don't know the name of the resident, you can just put in Governor Linden. And just put as much information as you can, and we'll go in and look through it. That fun stuff. We actually have a whole bunch of different, tips and tricks on how to report if, A, you don't know the name of the person that you're reporting, or if you can't get to the region itself, because for whatever reason, maybe it's crashed and you can't get in. Yeah, never a good idea to share exploits if you happen to know of any. That could land you into some trouble. We got about 10 more minutes left, so some time for some last minute questions and fun things. I'm not sure what you mean by mirrors and space invaders. You'd have to be a little bit more specific. So once you report somebody, it gets put into our system pretty much immediately, but depending on how quickly we actually physically get those reports depends on if it was, you know, reported in the proper section, also how many other reports that we have in the system. We have a lot, so it can take some time for us to get to them. Though occasionally it's always amusing whenever I also get invited into the conference call spam, because then I'm like, oh, hi, you invited the wrong person. Goodbye. It's usually what we do see when it comes to conference call spam. They usually try and hit some groups, and then we'll just put in other names. Sometimes they like to invite us to just, I don't know why, maybe just to get attention, but it's probably not the attention they want, because most of the time there are people who shouldn't be here anyways, so bad times when they invite me to their conference call spam. So if you're getting plopped onto a mailing list, you should always check to see if there's a way to unsubscribe first, and if there's instructions to unsubscribe, and check that first before reporting it to us. Yeah, the instructions do say to contact someone specifically. Always try and contact them, but if it's just getting hardcore, and you're more than welcome to file an abuse report, and we'll look into it and see if there's anything we can do. But it's generally case by case, depending. Totally had myself on mute, like a scrub.
So stuff.
A little bit. I had it double muted too, which is a skill of mine. But yeah, as I was saying, we have a couple minutes left, so now's the time for any last minute questions, comments, all that fun stuff. So speak now or forever hold your peace until the next time.
But make sure you take yourself off mute. Don't pull a Kristen.
Yep, that too. Right, I'm going to take that as nobody has any other questions, unless you're in the middle of typing. So. Oh, you do? Go for it. Space Invaders is a very fun game. I have a Space Invaders magnet. There might be some volunteer groups that exist within Second Life. I don't know all of them, but you might want to reach out to them and see what you can do to get with maybe some pre-existing groups or maybe make your own to try and help some people out. But I don't think we have anything official that I'm aware of. I can't really remember.
To my knowledge, I don't think we have any Linden Rand volunteer groups.
I don't think so either. I know there's a bunch of places within Second Life where people have their own little help groups and whatnot, which is fantastic. But yeah, I know Firestorm has a lot of cool stuff that helps out some people in their particular land. We'll pop in there eventually and say hi. On that note, I do need to run and go eat some lunch. So I will bid you guys a farewell. It's been nice chatting with you. Hopefully we'll see y'all next time. And we'll be updating the user group page for our next date. For the next day of the meeting and all that fun stuff. So hope you guys have a fantastic day. And you're welcome and thank you.